Joining us now is the Democratic candidate in that Pennsylvania House race, Conor Lamb. Good morning.
Good morning.
I hesitate to call you Congressman-elect because it feels a tad premature because these votes are still being counted. Why are you so confident?
Well, one of the strengths of my campaign all along has been that we have leadership by local people, and this is a local race run by local people. So we have people all over the district following this, and you know, they've seen a lot of elections here, and we feel confident about how it's going to turn out.
But, I mean, there are still, as at our latest count, 1,398 absentee and provisional ballots still being counted. So couldn't those swing the victory to your opponent, Rick Saccone?
It's possible. I mean, I don't know what the exact numbers are at this moment. But, again, you know, we feel confident based on the way we ran this and our efforts to get absentee ballots to the people that need them, that we're going to be competitive in that side of the ballot as well.
But, of course, as you know, your opponent, Rick Saccone, says that he is not giving up. Have you heard from him since you declared victory last night?
No, I have not.
And what do you think when he says that he's not giving up? We're going to fight this all the way to the end. And he says, you know, I never give up. We're fighting the fight.
Well, we've known that we were in a tough race here for, you know, the last 5 months. We expected to have a good fight on our hands, and we were willing to wage a pretty good fight ourselves. So I wouldn't really expect anything else. And, you know, I congratulate him on fighting hard the whole way.
So what do you think allowed you to have this incredibly close race and this probably narrow victory in this, you know, consistently red district?
Well, we worked very hard, and this is my home. So, you know, you call it a red district, I just call it Western Pennsylvania. And we worked extremely hard to get out and campaign in person over every square inch of this district. And I think just through talking to people, looking them in the eye, figuring out what the issues are from them, and then trying to come up with solutions to them, we seem to have reached a lot of people. And we saw a huge turnout yesterday on both sides, which I think is great. People around here are really engaged, and I was happy to be part of that excitement.
As you know, President Donald Trump came to your district to campaign for your opponent, Rick Saccone, but he did mention you a few times during that speech. So let me just remind everybody of what he said.
I mean, Nancy Pelosi, you can't have that. And Conor Lamb, Lamb the Sham, right? Lamb the Sham. He's trying to act like a Republican, so he won't give me one vote. Look, I don't know him. Looks like a nice guy. I hear he's nice looking. I think I'm better looking than him. I do. And he's slightly younger than me. Slightly.
There's a lot there to parse, Mr. Lamb. Why do you think that Lamb the Sham didn't take hold?
Well, I don't know. I mean, just apart from that, there was a lot of foolishness in this election and a lot of really cartoonish campaigning. And I think by the time of the president's visit last weekend, people were kind of tired of that entire approach. I mean, I had people, especially elderly people, coming up to me almost every day and just saying, man, I hate those ads against you. It's not right. It's not worthy of us. And so I think there was just a little bit of burnout on that type of campaigning before the president ever got here.
And do you think the president is better looking than you?
I really have no opinion on that one.
Strange. Do you think that this very close race and what appears to be your narrow victory, do you think it says something about Donald Trump?
Not really, other than to say that there are plenty of people here who are still pretty supportive of him, from what I can tell. I think that his visits, he came here twice, I think they probably did contribute to the turnout that we saw. And look, I was at a lot of polling places yesterday with cars parked outside of them that had President Trump's bumper sticker on them. So he's a popular person here. But I think that what happens when you campaign in real life as much as possible is that those divisions go away. Everyone gave me a fair shake, and I know that there are people that voted for the president who also voted for me. And, you know, I thank them for hearing me out, and, you know, I'm looking forward to fulfilling my promise of actually representing them.
Look, as you know, obviously you see this race as very individual and as about you, but lots of people look at it as a bellwether and as a symbol of something. And so they're trying to figure out if you're the model of a Democrat that can win in a district that leans red. And so, you know, your positions are interesting. I mean, you're obviously not straight up and down the kind of Democratic platform, you know? You were, I don't know, I mean, you can characterize it yourself. You're anti-gun control, I mean, I guess. You're, you know, personally pro-life. How do you explain your positions in the Democratic Party?
Well, I found that most people would rather talk about things on a case-by-case basis, and so we did that, and I did it honestly. You know, I describe myself as a Pennsylvania Democrat, looking to get things done, and especially to be for and represent working people. And so that's part of a long tradition here. I think people basically understand what it means, and it means that we will work with the other side if that's what it takes to bring jobs here or protect our people, and that seems to be what most people want around here.
You know you're going to have to do all of this again in 8 months.
That's true, yeah. It's a special election and a very special experience, let me tell you that.
But, I mean, does that mean you're going to immediately hit the campaign trail again?
Well, no. I mean, I made a promise to the people of this district, the 18th district, that I would campaign for them, that I would listen to them, and if I was given the opportunity, that I would serve them and them alone. And so I plan to spend the rest of this year fully representing the people of this district and fulfilling the promise that I made. And, you know, we'll let the rest of it shake out, but there's a lot of work to be done just in, you know, trying to bring solutions to the problems that we talked about for the last 6 months.
All right, Conor Lamb, obviously we'll be watching very closely as these roughly 1,400 absentee ballots continue to be counted during our program. Thanks so much for being on New Day.
Thank you.